Hello everyone, Namaste. Welcome to video lecture. I am Lokesh, Assistant Professor, Department of Commerce, Soundarya Institute of Management and Science, Siddharthahalli, Bangalore. Dear friends, today I am going to discuss commodity market. In commodity market, I would like to discuss few contents are as below. History of commodity market, factors affecting to the commodity markets, functions or benefits of commodity market, types of contract or transactions in commodity market, difference between physical market and future market, what are the various participants of commodity markets. These are all the topics which I am going to discuss today under the commodity market. Dear friends, let us discuss history of commodity market. The commodity market plays an important role in our daily life. We can be found various type of commodities all over the world, and it can be traded on the global market. It is not only a domestic, even global market. In fact, of billion of dollars invested on commodity every day, and it can be traded on either in spot market or physical market, what we can call, or future market. Commodity market, let us discuss the brief history. Commodity market was started in 19th century in Japan. In Japan, merchants were used to store rice, wheat, or any agriculture products in warehouse for future use, to raise cash warehouse holders sold receipt against the stored rice or wheat. Later, this activity converted as commodity activity. In the 19th century at Chicago, which is in USA, major commodity activities started gradually. Seller and buyer started to making commitment of exchanging the product for cash in future. This process become very profitable, which encourages to other country to participate in commodity market. In India, what is the major trust for integration of commodity market was given by European. Voyage of discovery and the merge of world trade towards the globalization, the advancement in shipping and other transport technology had facilitated the growth of trade in segment. The commodity trade among the different country was originated much before voyage of Columbus and Vasco da Gama. In India, 19th century, the first commodity association started at Mumbai or in Bombay. That is cotton textile industry. In 1912, raw jute and jute goods association started at Hapur, which is in West Bengal. In 1952, forward contract regulatory authority, what we can call FCRA, came into exist. In India, there are three regulatory authorities, namely FMC, Forward Market Commission, which is most powerful regulatory authority. FCRA, which I told now, Forward Contract Regulatory Authority. Then CGDA, Contract Government Department of Affairs. This is the very important important which we would like to discuss about history of commodity market. Let us move to the meaning of commodity. Commodity means any movable property other than actionable clients such as money and securities. It may be any movable property other than the actionable clients, securities or money. Securities, shares that can be traded in a stock market. So it's of other than actionable clients such as money and securities is called commodity. In other words, commodity refers to any material which can be bought and sold. This is what commodity. Let us see some example. Or for instance, what are the various commodity in agricultural products? It may be rice, wheat, jute, tea, sugar, coffee, etc. In the livestock, fish, meat, etc. Energy, you can take crude oil, natural gas, heating oil, etc. Then metals, silver, gold, platinum, even diamond. These are all the various examples of commodity. Now let us move to the commodity market. So till now we discussed only the commodity, what are the various commodities. Now commodity market. Market is a place where we can be bought and sold. It refers to the market that trade in primary rather than manufacturing product. This is very important, keep in your mind. It refers to the market that trade in primary product rather than manufacturing product, like rice, wheat, crude oil, all examples. In other words, it is a place where buying and selling of movable property are taking place, even NCDX, NMCE, MCX, ICX, etc. These are all the various stock exchanges in India. That we'll discuss later. What is NCDX, NMCE, MCX, ICX? Now, what are the various factors to the commodity? What are the various factors to the commodity markets? What are the various factors are affecting to the commodity market? Let us discuss one by one. First one is demand and supply. Demand and supply is very, very important. Based on the demand, based on the supply, the prices will be changed. Demand and supply are basic factors that affect the movement of commodity prices. When the supply is increased, automatically demand will decrease, even price also decrease. When supply is less, or when the supply is decline or decrease, create the demand and prices also will increase. This is what demand and supply. Second one is demand curve. It represents the relationship between the price of the commodity and purchasing power of consumer. That we have discussed in economics also. Demand curve. This is what depends. It's a relationship between the price of the commodity and purchasing power of consumer. For example, rice, wheat, any agricultural product. That is the price of 1 kg, price of that quantity into purchasing power of consumer. This is what demand curve. Risk and return. High return is followed by high risk. Medium return is followed by medium risk. Even less return is followed by less risk. It's based on investment capacity of investors and capacity to take risk. Fourth one is global and domestic economy. Economy scenario significantly affect the price movement of commodity. Even demand and supply of any commodity has a direct relationship with the economic conditions of the society. In this COVID-19, it is in this era, definitely it is a huge impact on global and domestic economy. Fifth one, economic growth. Economic growth of the world as well as domestic economy is an important fundamental that affect the demand and supply position of the country. Sixth one, extraordinary event. I mean, these events like natural calamities, even deflation, inflation, earthquake, flood, war, etc. affect the commodity prices in a domestic way. For example, in this COVID-19, you see the petroleum product, right? Tremendous changes in that. Seventh one, speculation. Speculation brings information to the system at a time or in order to trigger the price movement in a particular direction. Then inflation. During the time of inflation, value of the price decreases. Especially in the value of the price decreases and the commodity price increases. This is very, very important. Just you can listen. Value of in the during the time of inflation, value of the prices will be decreasing and commodity price will be increasing. It will also affect the commodity market. This is inflation. Then even political condition. The political factors have a different as well as indirect effect on commodity market. Obviously, it will affect. Then deflation, which is not inflation, means opposite to the inflation, that is deflation. Means deflation during the time of deflation, the value of the money increases and commodity price decreases. It will also affect to the commodity market. Look at here, in the inflation, value of the price of the decreases and commodity price increases in inflation. But when you come to the deflation, during the time of deflation, the value of the money increases and the commodity price decreases. Both will affect to the commodity market. After this, let us move to the what are the benefits or functions of commodity market. Let us see both in the one slide. First one is the price discovery. Based on the import regarding specific market information, the demand and supply condition, weather forecast, expert views, and inflation rate, government policies, market dynamics, even buyers, sellers, conduct at future exchanges, this transforms into continuous price discovery. This is which we are going to understand. Next one is useful for the consumer. See, definitely it's very much useful for the consumers because see, consumer only came to know through the commodity market what are the prices, what available, everything will be decided in the commodity market. Next one is import export competitiveness. The exporter can hedge their price risk and even improve their competitiveness by making use of future market. A majority of the traders which are involved in physical trade, what we can call spot trade, that we'll discuss in a spot, physical, forward, future, everything. Trade internationally intended to buy forwards, even importer also. Next one is, the fourth one is predictable pricing. Predictable is nothing but a forecast pricing. The demand for certain commodities is highly price elastic. The manufacturers have to ensure that price should be stable in order to protect their market share with the free entry of import. Future contract will enable profitability in domestic prices. Fifth one, benefit for farmers and agriculturists. Especially this type of function or benefits very much important in a commodity market because in India is a basically farmers country, even agriculturist also, right? 70% of the people they are depend on agriculture. What are the benefits? How the benefit for farmers and agriculturists? Commodity market helps to the farmers to reduce the risk premium associated with marketing or processing margins, enabling more return on produced. Recently, the government also has made amendment on APMC regarding avoiding the middleman or commission agent. Now, the farmers can directly sell the product to the wholesalers. That they are going to happening now. Next one is, sixth one is credit accessibility. Hedging, which is possible through future market, would cut down the discount in commodity reading. Then improved product quality. The existence of warehouse for facilitating delivery with grading facilities along with other related benefits provides a very strong reason to upgrade and enhance the quality of the commodity to trade to grade that is acceptable by the exchange. In India, there is a two concept warehousing, that is one CWC, Central Warehouse Corporation. Even in Karnataka State Government, KSWC, Karnataka State Warehouse Corporations, they will maintain and upgrade and enhance the quality of the commodity or good, any goods and services to grade that is acceptable by the exchange. Eighth one is commodity as an asset class diversification of portfolio of risk. I mean, commodity has an historical and inverse correlation of daily returns has compared to equality. Correlation is nothing but analysis of the two variables, variance. And finally, useful to the producer. Obviously, commodity trade is useful, very much useful to the producer, because he or she can get an idea of the price likely to prevail on a future date, therefore can decide between various competing commodities the best that suits in. That is what. Now, the one more role of commodity exchange. I think the role and benefits are functions all are similar. So I don't want to explain all, just I will read out. Opportunity to first one is, what is the role of a commodity exchange? The first one is opportunity to invest in commodity, establishing global benchmark, price hedging, speculation, profit motive, national income, encourage capital formation, provide safety and security in dealing, service as an economic barometer, management of risk, efficiency in trading, promotion of exporter or importer, promotion of farmer and merchant, meet the needs of customers, price stabilization. That is very important in the, these are all the role of commodity exchange. Let us move to the very important, what are the different types of contract in commodity market or transactions in commodity market which we are going to discuss. There are four different types of the contract or transactions are made in commodity market. The first one is spot market or contract. We can call one more name, physical market or cash market. Second one is forward contract. Third one is future contract. Fourth one is options market. But in India, there is no concept of forward contract. But anyway, we are going to discuss about the knowledge point of view. Even spot market, forward market, future market or contract and options market. Let us discuss one by one. Spot market or physical market, I mean, refers to a transaction, refers to a transaction for immediate delivery, the delivery of the commodity on the spot. It involves prompt exchange of goods for cash. This is what. Look at the one example. If you are a farmer, for example, I am Lokesh, I am a farmer or a dealer of rice or wheat. You can take rice. I'm a farmer or dealer of rice product, agriculture product, and you have or someone have physical holding of 10 kg of rice with you, which you want to sell in the market. You can do so by selling your holdings in either of the three commodities which I told you, three commodity exchanges in India, in spot market at the existing market or spot price. In this contract, right, immediately physical exchange of the delivery of the commodities, immediately they will give the goods, they will get the cash. That's why spot market. Okay, this is what. Second one is forward contract or market. A forward contract is that specifies the transfer of ownership of commodity at future date in a time. Today, the buyer and seller agree on all the contract term, including price, quantity, quality, location, and delivery date. This is a very important concept, but in India, we don't have this type of contract. It was earlier, it was there. Now, we are not. That's why I am not giving much importance for this. Let us go for the similar type of this forward. That is a future contract or future contract. Now, future contract or specific type of followed contract which traded on organized exchanges, organized commodity exchanges such as ICX, NCX, that we'll discuss in the next class, okay? What is the, commodity futures, what we can call futures contract, right? A futures contract is an agreement for buying or selling of commodity for a predetermined delivery price at a specific future time. Futures are standardized contracts that are traded on organized future exchanges. This is a future contract. Let us see the one example. Suppose a farmer is expecting his crop of rice or wheat, we can take wheat, to be ready in 2 months time, but is worried about the price of wheat may decline or decrease in this period. In order to minimize his risk, he can enter into a future contract or market to sell his crop or wheat in 2 months time at a price determined now. This way, he is able to hedge his risk arising from a possible adverse change in the price of his commodity. This is very simple. Today is going that he has grown up the wheat or any rice. He wants to sell after 3 months or 2 months. He thought maybe the prices will decrease. That is a predictable price. That's why he's going to make the agreement now for the future date. This is what future contract example. Last one is option market. See, when we option market is when we have the option, when we have the choice, choose the best, otherwise do the best. Commodity market provides option to the buyer and sellers to purchase the commodity or sell the commodity, but there is no obligation to do so. In options, there are two different types of options. One is call options, right to buy. Another one is put option, right to sell. One is call option, put option. Call option is the right to buy. Put option is the right to sell. So let us discuss the options market. See, when option market is like also futures or forward market, options are also financial instruments used for hedging and speculation. The commodity option holder has the right but not the obligations, which I already told you, to buy or sell a specific quantity of a commodity at a specified price on or before a specified date. Option contracts involve two parties, that is, the seller of the option writes the option in favor of the buyer or holder of that commodity, who pays a certain premium to the seller as a price for the option. Here already I told you there are the two different types in option. Basically two types of commodities. Now, one is call option, another one is a put option. Let us have an example, then it's very easy to understand. A call option, right? It gives the buyer the right to buy the asset or any commodity. You can take rice, wheat, whatever the commodity, at a given price. This given price is called strike price. Keep in your mind, given price is nothing but a strike price, right? It's very important. It gives the buyer, I'll repeat, it gives the buyer the right to buy the asset or commodity at a given price. This given price is called strike price. Let us have an example. For instance, the call option. Mr. A bought a call at a strike price, given price of rupees 500. On expiry, the price of the asset is rupees 450, 500 rupees less. Mr. A will not exercise his call because he can buy the same asset from the market at rupees 450 rather than paying rupees 500 to the seller of the option. Here, what we are going to understand, Mr. A is getting 50 rupees profit, right? But anyway, the given price is 500 rupees, but after few months, after the expiry of the price, asset is 450, then he will not exercise his call because he can buy the same asset from the market at rupees 450. 50 rupees is getting profit, right? Rather than 500 rupees. This is what a call option. Then if you take the put option opposite to that, it gives the buyer opposite to the call option. The put option gives the buyer a right to sell the asset at the strike price or given price to the buyer. Here the buyer has the right to sell and the seller has the obligation to buy. Let us see one example. Mr. B bought a put at a strike price or a given price of rupees 600. On expiry, the price of the asset is rupees 619 rupees. Mr. B will not exercise his put option because he can sell the same asset in the market at rupees 619 rather than giving it to the seller of the put option for rupees 600. What he can do? He will not sell. He can sell 619 rupees. 19 rupees is getting profit. That's why he will not exercise, because he can sell the same asset in the market at rupees 619 rather than giving it to the seller of the put option for rupees 600. This is the beauty of options market. Now let us move to the very important thing, differences between physical market and future market. Already we know the different types of markets, physical or spot or cash market. Second one is forward market, third one is future market, fourth one is options market. What are the differences between physical or spot market and future market? Let us see physical market, future market. In the physical market, delivery of goods takes place immediately. That's why we can call it the physically. Physical is nothing but immediately they will exchange of the goods and services on the spot only. But in the future market, delivery of the goods takes place in a future date. That I was giving the example in the future, that there is a rice merchant, right? That merchant or the rice farmer, he will make the contract, but there is no possibility to movement of the goods. That will take place in the expiry date. Then in the physical market, settlement of cash takes place on the spot. But in the future market, settlement of cash takes place in the future date. In the physical market, spot market are not speculative in nature, but in future it's speculative in nature because it's unpredictable prices. It may increase or decrease. Then physical market, dealers are stuck at the spot prices. Here in the future, dealers are stuck at the future prices. In the physical market, there is no price risk, but there is a price risk in future market due to the fluctuation in the future price. We don't know after 1 month, after maybe tomorrow what will happen, we don't know. Due to the market fluctuations, the prices will change. There is a more risk also, right? Then in the physical market, availability of the market or infrastructure is necessary because the person can buy and sell on the spot with the help of infrastructure. But in the future market, availability of the market or infrastructure is not necessary, okay, because there is a future agreement or contract. Then physical market, anyone can participate in the spot market, but in the future market is a depend on the contract. They can be participated. Dear friends, let us move to the participants of commodity market. There are many participants. The mainly is hedgers. We know that hedgers, they use derivatives markets to reduce or eliminate the risk associated with price of a commodity. They trade in the futures market to transfer their risk of movement in prices of the commodity. They are actually physically dealing. Okay, some of the hedgers, if you see this, like exporters, you know that exporters, right? People who need protection against the higher prices of commodities contracted from a future delivery but not yet purchased. The example already given, the exporter, even importer, even farmer, right? Farmers, then the various different categories, they are comes under the hedgers. Next, second one is speculators. Speculators are those who may not have an interest in the ready contracts, etc., but see an opportunity of price movement favorable to them. They provide depth and liquidity to the market. They provide a useful economic function and are integral part of the futures, the market. It would not be wrong to say that in absence of speculators, the market will not liquid and may at times collapse. That is also possible. This is in the third one is arbitrages. Arbitrage refers to the simultaneous purchase and sale in two markets. Simultaneously they can buy and sell, right? Simultaneous in the market so that the selling price is higher than the buying price by more than the transaction's cost, resulting in riskless profit. So these are all the three different types of participants of commodity market. Now finally we'll move to the what are the risk faced by participants in derivative market. There are many risks we are participating. The first one is financial risk. It includes the cash settlement in commodity market, even arrangement of the finance and sources of finance to invest in the commodity market. All are comes under in a financial risk. Of course, credit risk credit risk is an account of default by counterparty. Credit risk is very low in commodity market because exchange formulating rules for performance of contract. Then market risk, you know that market always fluctuate. It is a risk of loss on account of adverse movement of prices or fluctuation of the prices. Then liquidity risk, it is the risk faced by the participator because of unwinding of transaction if the market is illiquid. After that, the legal risk, it is the legal objection might be raised, regulatory framework might disallow some activity. This is what legal. Then operational risk, it is the risk arising out of some operational difficulties like failure of electricity, even connectivity due to which it become difficult to operate in market. These are all the various risks are faced by participants in derivatives market. So this is the brief introduction about commodity market which we discussed. And before concluding this concept, just let us discuss the differences between stock and commodity market. Because there are the two markets which are very, very important in India, even not only in India, in the world. In stock market, the stocks or any mutual funds that are traded, whereas in the commodity market, commodities like gold, silver, rice, wheat, coal, that etc., they are traded. But when you come to it is in the stock market that shares of different companies are traded. For example, Infosys, TCS, all the companies trade there every day, except Saturday and Sunday, every day it's trading. It's more liquidity also. But whereas in the commodity market, commodities of various categories are traded. Next, in commodity market, there is a possibility of taking physical delivery of commodities. That is in the spot market, but in the stock market, deals only in financial assets which are intangible and invisible. That is through the help of dematerialization account. That is what intangible, everything is in electronic mode. And finally, in the stock market is less volatility comparatively commodity market. So that's why even commodity market is more risky than stock market. Thank you.